Most men your age, High, are getting married and raising up a family.
Well, factually,
they wouldn't accept prison as a substitute. Would any of you men care to comment?
Well, sometimes your career's got to come before family.
It's propaganda by Russian version. You go in there and they brainwash you. And we had to eat a baked potato to stay warm.
Okay, just say, buck, 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 buck. I'll take a chicken over here on number 7. Okay, got a chicken on number 6, chicken on number 7, chicken on number 1. I think we're good to go. Hi, welcome to Comedy Parenting Radio, the show that finds asparagus useful in filming bee monster movies.
It makes perfect tentacles.
Oh no,
it's the horror movie coming this summer, where one lonely kid will be in the dining room forced to eat his food.
Hey Dad, check out these top 10 most active countries that listen to Comedy Parenting Radio.
Top 10 countries, what are they, Josh?
Other.
Wait, what kind of a country is other? Is that near Norway?
No, it says other.
Okay, the other country.
Korea. Italy, Mexico, Ireland, Germany, Australia, Canada, New Zealand, United Kingdom, and United States.
Cool. Today's topic is sore losers. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
At highway speeds, the average text takes your eyes off the road for about 5 seconds. That's enough time to travel the length of a football field. Stop texts. StopWrecks.org. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council. At highway speeds, the average text takes your eyes off the road for about 5 seconds. That's enough time to travel the length of a football field. Stop texts. StopWrecks.org. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council. History gets made
when you're acting a fool. Comedy.
Parenting.
Radio.
Okay, who's the most sore person in our household these days?
That's a good question.
Anybody want to rate their soreness on a scale of 1 to 10? 1 being, I didn't know I was sore, and number 10 being, I'm pretty much got rigor mortis setting in.
I'm probably like a 7.
A 7? How can you even walk?
For my age, I'd probably be about a 6 constantly.
Is this like dog years, or what is this?
I'm probably about a 0.00000000000000001%.
Yeah, you came downstairs so happy this morning and dancing, and I was like this blob on the floor.
So is the loser on this list the person with the most soreness or the least soreness?
I'll tell you what I'm sore from.
What are you sore from?
Hanging Christmas lights.
Oh, boy.
Okay, so not you don't just, like, hang them, like...
Tie them in a noose. Wah, wah, wah. Wada, wada.
No. It's you put up Christmas lights.
How many lights, Dad?
We're supposed to put up 500,000 lights.
That's a lot of lights.
I know. So a lot of them get stapled up, like with a cable stapler. Ch-king, 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 ch-king. And guess what? 2 staples per light.
Per light, huh?
I wake up and my hands are like arthritic. I can't move until I find coffee. Then they...
So technically, you stapled... You're going to have stapled 1,000,000 staples.
Technically. Except for we don't staple them all. If we don't staple them, then we hang them in trees. But you don't just hang them. You have to wrap them around the branch.
Oh.
I could see that proving difficult to... have a tree which has trees, branches, and then branches off of that, and then branches off of that.
So you turn it into Charlie Chaplin with your arm just going around in circles, and it gets sore from doing that all day.
Yeah, and then I walk away, and it's still going like that, still rapping, and people think that I'm... What would that be?
Conducting.
Being weirdo.
No, it looks like I'm calling people toward me, so All these people are like, you called me over here. What are you guys sore about?
Josiah stealing my free tacos.
Wait, that's a different kind of sore?
That is also a type of sore.
So what's this show about?
Sore
all types of soreness.
Oh, any kind of soreness.
See.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, what did the show have to do with losers?
We're all a bunch of losers.
And we're sore.
Therefore, this show is the logical end product of that.
Now, here's a weird sore loser thing that happened one time. Is a relative of mine wrote a letter about him having a sore throat, and he spelled sore, S-O-A-R.
A sore throat, huh?
Yeah, a sore throat. So.
Wouldn't you be soaring if you were a winner?
I could picture his throat up in the air going around and around like a bird.
Don't you know that's one of the most common places to get sore throats is on an airplane?
Ooh.
I got pneumonia on Lufthansa once coming back from Germany. It's true.
Huh.
Doctor said, you have walking pneumonia.
Walking?
I'm thinking it was flying pneumonia.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm glad that that walking pneumonia walked out on you.
Yeah. You're listening to Comedy Parenting Radio, Sore Losers. Hang on. We'll be right back.
Dr. Park and Cindy Klein, I'm not surprised to see you here. You've got smokers cough from smoking, brewers droop from drinking beer. I don't know how you came to get the Betty Davis knees, but worst of all, young man, you've got industrial disease.
Confessions of a Potentially Perfect Parent, brought to you by AdoptUsKids.org.
I know more about cooking dinner for a party of 12 than about packing a lunch for a 12-year-old. I know kids like things like fish sticks. Filets, I get, but sticks? Maybe we can just compromise on mac and cheese. Can you make that with Brie?
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you. Call 1-888-200-4005 or visit AdoptUsKids.org for more information. A message from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, AdoptUsKids, and the Ad Council.
Why are there suddenly three people up there next to the king? That one is the cupbearer, the second one is the scribe, and the third one plays episodes of Comedy Parenting Radio.
Work boots, one blue suit, size too small, don't wear it at all. Unless somebody kicks, gets hitched, it don't fit, it makes me itch. Up with the sun, off on the run, making money, money, cause I wanna have fun.
You're back with Comedy Parenting Radio, Sore Losers. I've also been sore from shoveling gravel, the gold standard in doing manual labor.
I can relate.
When you get sore, not only are you sore, like your back is sore, your arms are sore, you have blisters too.
Mm-hmm. My first time shoveling a large amount of gravel, I was a smart boy and didn't wear any gloves. And so by the end of the day, my hands looked like they went through...
What's that stuff they inject under the skin?
Botox.
It looks like your hands went through Botox.
But I did shovel close to 7 tons, so... Yeah.
Any other soreness?
I have been doing so much walking recently.
How much
running.
Walking have you been doing?
He's probably walking
a lot.
6 miles.
I've probably walked about halfway across America by now.
Doing what?
Everything. I've done kickball. I've done walking to work. I've done walking.
Well, how far is work?
A ways away, 3 or 4 miles.
Oh, yeah.
Back in my day, we used to walk 15 miles each way to school.
And we had to eat a baked potato to stay warm.
In Joshua's case, it actually is uphill both ways.
Mm-hmm. It is.
Wait.
It is?
Uh-huh. When you go over hill and dale and hill and dale, there's a lot of uphill and a lot of downhill. Mm-hmm. And back uphill and back downhill and back uphill.
It's like going across zigzag. You're going to go up and down and up and down on return.
So what part of you is sore?
What part of me isn't sore? It's not only the walking, but it's that I have to rush and rush whenever I get to work. My mouth muscles are whistling. Or sore from grinning because work is fun.
Your cheeks are sore from grinning?
Yep.
I'd love to work at that place. Where do you work?
A good spot.
Go to Slow Groovin'. Wait, Slow Groovin' Restaurant is not open during the winter.
Do not go to Slow Groovin' Restaurant in Marble. Go to Slow Groovin' Restaurant in Snowmass or Propaganda Pie in Redstone.
Okay, go to Snowmass, Colorado, ski area, Slow Groovin'. Awesome, awesome barbecue. Or Propaganda Pie, which is a new pizza place in Redstone, Colorado.
Yes,
check it out.
When you go to Propaganda Pie, the whole place is red. Not because we intended it that way. Someone spilled meat sauce.
It's propaganda pie Russian version. You go in there and they brainwash you.
I'm kind of afraid to go to this pizza place.
Oh, do not worry. On the way out, the pizza will be so good, it might just cure you.
Kill me or cure me? What did he say?
It is up for you to decide.
Josiah, we're going to have to send a mole in to eat the pizza.
A mole?
Please don't. That's not going to go over well with the food inspector.
Yes, it is not going to go well with the health inspector, but thankfully we got rid of him last week.
Okay. Anybody else sore from anything?
I'm sore about ticks.
What kind of ticks?
All sorts of ticks.
Everything that makes anything tick.
Like politics?
Oh, pollen ticks. Those are the worst. They carry diseases, germs, and bacteria, but they are very good for pollination.
You can get sore, though. That's what they say. If you feel sore, achy, you probably get... Probably got
Rocky Mountain spotted fever.
From a politic. Anybody ever been sore from hauling too much stuff, moving, helping other people move?
Yes.
I'm sore from being pulled away from the delicious chocolate cake that I was eating when I was ordered to go get wood.
You ate chocolate cake before we went and got firewood?
Wait, he ate chocolate cake before we went and got firewood?
That was my chocolate cake.
It was actually Josiah's.
I didn't see any chocolate cake.
You never got any of the chocolate cake?
No.
It was literally delicious.
That's because Elijah ate it.
Some of our cast members are losing it over there. One of them just dropped to the floor.
He's sore.
He's not breathing.
Not anymore.
Laughing.
Has anyone ever had a stomach hurt from laughing so much?
Oh, yeah.
No, not my stomach.
We've all had that happen.
It's generally my abdominals.
That is your stomach.
That's great. It starts with an earthquake. Birds and snakes and airplane. Lenny Bruce is not afraid.
This moment of uncontrollable laughter was made possible by a 32-year-old man with little to no coordination attempting to execute a simple cartwheel. His name is Sergeant Warner, but young James, our laughing friend here, simply calls him Dad. The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today. Call 877-4DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
Move to the back of the bus, folks. Fill up the back seats.
Good grief.
Why don't you guys sit in the back of the bus?
Because you're playing Comedy Printing Radio up here, and we want to hear it.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go,
please, Mr. Custer, I don't want to go.
Stop it now.
Here I am at Camp Granada.
Music's playing up and down the block.
Has anyone ever been sore from sitting in the car too long on a trip?
You have.
You have.
I'm the only one that gets sore sitting in the car on a long trip.
It's because you're the only one that has to sit still.
And you're the only one who has, like, 3-seat cushions.
I have bought every kind of thing to make it more comfortable to sit in the car for long periods of time. Oh, my word. It's just the stuff on my back, underneath, the little massagey things. I tried heat once. That didn't work.
Vibrating chair.
Really, I think if I could just drive like about 20 miles and get out of the car, it'd be fine.
Mm-hmm.
But what kind of a car trip is that? We can't even get to the grocery store.
How about sports teams? Do you think they ever are sore losers?
Yeah, the Cubs.
Tell me about the Cubs being sore losers.
Why do the Cubs have so many massage therapists at the end of their games?
I don't know why.
Because they're sore losers.
Have you ever been a sore loser about sports?
Me?
Yes.
I never got off the bench. If I had gotten off the bench and we lost, I would have been a sore loser, but I didn't have any skin in the game, that's for sure. You've heard of A team, B team, and C team?
You were the Omega team, right?
The F team.
They thought I was the water boy. I'm like, no, I'm one of the players. Hello? Why do they always ask me to go get more water? So, no, I've never been a sore loser about sports.
Elijah has.
I have?
You have.
You ever throw ski poles and you lose a ski race? golf clubs, you lose a golf game or miss a good swing or throw a pizza at someone when your pizza's burnt.
Yep.
Or maybe throwing that little tiny shoe at people when you lose at Monopoly.
The only time I did a ski race is I raced up against Courtney, and I lost by like a second or two. Because when she first took off, there was this little plastic thing that looked like it was solid, but wasn't. And I was waiting for it to, I don't know, move out of the way so I could go. And she took off down the half. She had about a 4-second head start, but I narrowed it down to about 2 seconds.
That's called the wand.
Yeah, I didn't
you
realize...
You push it open and your time starts.
I didn't really want to touch it just because I broke it.
I think it's about time to wrap this one up and throw it in the diaper pail. Thanks for coming up in the studio today, gang.
You're welcome. You're it was welcome. Quite the slog you're with welcome. These sore muscles.
And before you guys go...
Kay.
Could you hand me that bottle of ibuprofen over there?
I don't...
I'm going to use it first.
Yeah.
Bye-bye. And they were sore afraid.